The United States took a bold step toward redefining naval power projection. The unmanned surface vessel, USV, USX-1 Defiant, built for the NOMARS program, began an extended at-sea demonstration of endurance, autonomy, and resilience. NOMARS means no manning required ship. This trial is more than just a test. It marks a potential paradigm shift in how navies operate, expanding the role of unmanned platforms from small surveillance boats to ocean-going vessels capable of operating without human crew. In a world of rising maritime threats, this development could have far-reaching consequences for naval strategy, fleet composition, and global power projection. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why USX-1 Defiant's extended trial under US Navy NOMARS program is crucial development. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The USX-1 Defiant is the first medium-sized surface vessel designed from the keel up to operate without any human crew. Built under the NOMARS program led by the DARPA, with prime contractor Serco Inc., it is a 180-foot-long, 240-metric-ton lightship, meaning its hull is simplified, compact, and optimized for autonomous operations rather than human comfort or habitability. The NOMARS program directly challenges traditional naval shipbuilding by removing every requirement tied to human habitability, berthing, life support, and onboard safety systems, and instead creating a streamlined hull designed solely for endurance, efficiency, and long-term operational resilience. By dispensing with berths, galleys, passageways, and life support systems, the designers reclaim valuable deck space and reduce the ship's size, complexity, and cost. Importantly, the Defiant proved it could perform essential seamanship tasks autonomously: navigation, docking, undocking, harbor entry and exit, and even automated refueling at sea, a capability historically reserved for crewed vessels. It also reached a top speed of about 23 miles per hour, 37 kilometers per hour during trials, showing it can keep pace with some fleet operations. These milestones confirm that USX-1 is not just a remote-controlled test boat. It is a true autonomous ship capable of sustained, crewless operations over extended periods, potentially even in open ocean. The extended at-sea demonstration of Defiant is designed to test several critical capabilities and validate whether the NOMARS concept can transition from experimental prototype to operational asset. 1. Autonomous endurance and seaworthiness. The vessel must demonstrate reliability in a variety of conditions, including rough seas, storms, and prolonged patrols. The NOMARS program aims for a 90% reliability rate over a one-year deployment. 2. Sustainable logistics without onboard crew. Automated fueling at sea, FAS, is essential for long-duration missions and has already been demonstrated successfully using a separate refueling vessel. 3. Hydrodynamic efficiency and stealth. The narrow hull and low superstructure, possible because there's no need for crew spaces, reduces radar cross-section and wake, improving both speed and stealth when configured for mission systems. 4. Modularity and mass production potential. The simplified hull design allows Defiant-class ships to be built in smaller commercial shipyards, Tier 3, not just specialized naval yards. That could allow rapid fleet scaling at lower cost. 5. Mission flexibility. While the current prototype is unarmed, the design envisions modular mission payloads, surveillance, logistics, electronic warfare, mine countermeasures, or even missile launchers, making each Defiant a multi-purpose node depending on configuration. The USX-1 Defiant's extended NOMARS trial carries strategic significance that could reshape naval warfare by shifting force design from a few large crewed capital ships toward many distributed, mission-tailored, uncrewed vessels. If crewless ships prove reliable and cost-effective at scale, navies can deploy persistent forward presence with far lower manpower and sustainment burdens, complicating an adversary's targeting calculus and enabling continuous surveillance, sea control, and denial operations across vast theaters. Removing the constraint of habitability frees hull designers to prioritize low-cost, modular payload bays and reduce signatures, allowing rapid role changes. Industrially, the Defiant concept opens production to a broader base of commercial shipyards and shorter build cycles, increasing surge capacity and resilience in peacetime and conflict. Politically and operationally, crewless ships lower the threshold for risk. Commanders can send autonomous platforms into high-threat zones without risking sailors' lives, enabling more aggressive presence and attrition strategies. At the same time, a distributed USV fleet forces adversaries to defend against numerous small, hard-to-find targets rather than a handful of large vessels, stretching their surveillance and strike resources and raising the cost of effective counters. However, this advantage depends on solving hard technical and doctrinal problems. Robust autonomy in contested environments, secure resilient communications, logistics for remote repair and refueling, and clear legal and command frameworks for employment. If NOMARS and Defiant overcome those hurdles, they will not simply add a new class of platform, they will catalyze a doctrinal transformation toward networked, unmanned maritime architectures that prioritize persistence, scalability, and risk-tolerant operations, fundamentally altering how states project power and defend the seas. Over the years, DARPA has enabled many cutting-edge technologies for the U.S. military, and this could be another one. The extended sea trial of Defiant represents a critical inflection point. If successful, the USX-1 will validate the feasibility of crewless, long-duration, ocean-going naval vessels, paving the way for a new class of naval force, distributed, autonomous, modular fleets. In the coming months, we will look to see whether Defiant completes a full, long-duration cruise, survives adverse weather, demonstrates communication resilience, and perhaps, and eventually, carries a mission payload. A successful demonstration could lead to rapid procurement and deployment of dozens or even hundreds of similar USVs across the fleet, dramatically expanding presence, surveillance, and strike capacity. For potential adversaries, this changes the calculus. Instead of facing a small number of large crewed ships, they may confront a distributed swarm of cheap, replaceable autonomous vessels, much harder to track, target, and neutralize. For navies worldwide, it signals a shift, not incremental, but potentially revolutionary, from crewed capital ships to autonomous, networked, mission-tailored surface fleets. If USX-1 Defiant succeeds, the United States may truly usher in a new era of naval warfare, one where the sea is patrolled, controlled, and fought over by ghost ships,